Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends, to your younger brothers and sisters who would want to take up engineering, and to your relatives. If you find my videos interesting and important to your studies, then also please don't forget to subscribe. So in this video, I'm going to show that an inscribed angle or peripheral angle, which is denoted alpha here, is one half the measure of its subtended arc. So this peripheral angle or inscribed angle alpha subtends arc BD, in this case of a circle, and this arc BD is described by the measure of the angle beta. So in other words, let us show that alpha is half of one half of beta. And I'm going to present three cases. One is we have point A here. This is alpha. This is another position of A, called this A prime. And it subtends the same arc BD. So that's why the measure of this angle is also alpha. And lastly, when A prime or point A, the limiting position is it coincides with points B or point D. And when that happens, this is still the subtended arc defined by this chord BD and this tangent here. So if this is the tangent line at B, then this tangent line and the radius are perpendicular to each other. So that's it. So the first way is, let's consider point A. And as mentioned earlier, let us show that alpha is half of the corresponding central angle, or half the measure of this subtended arc. Measure of the angle occupied by its subtended arc. So alpha, let us show that alpha is one half of beta. So first, let's draw a line from point A to point C, which is the center of the circle. And therefore, this is also the radius. Therefore, triangle ACD is an isosceles triangle because AC is the radius, CD is also the radius. So if we denote this angle here as P, then this angle is, the measure of this angle is also P. And if we denote this angle here as delta, then in this triangle ACD, delta is equal to 180 degrees minus 2 times P. Remember that the sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Also note that each interior angle of a triangle, this triangle ABD, is called an inscribed or peripheral angle also. So in particular, let's just consider point A, and it is an inscribed or peripheral angle with measure of angle alpha. So again, delta is 180 degrees minus 2 times P. So likewise, because AC is the radius, BC is also radius, then triangle ACB is also an isosceles triangle. Therefore, if the peripheral angle at A is alpha, then the measure of this angle here, in particular angle CAB, is equal to alpha minus P. So that is alpha minus P. This is also alpha minus P because triangle ACB is an isosceles triangle. So angle CBA is also alpha minus P, as indicated here. Therefore, if I denote this, the measure of this angle as epsilon, then epsilon is equal to 180 degrees minus 2 times quantity alpha minus P. So epsilon equals 180 degrees minus 2 times quantity up alpha minus p. Then lastly, around point C, this point C here, the total angle here, one revolution is 360 degrees. That is delta plus epsilon plus beta equals 360 degrees. So that's a complete revolution. So substitute the value of delta, which is 180 degrees minus 2 times p, epsilon, which is quantity, which is 180 degrees minus 2 times quantity alpha minus p, then plus beta equals 360 degrees. Simplifying by expanding, 180 degrees minus 2 times p plus 180 degrees minus 2 times alpha plus 2 times p plus beta equals 360 degrees. So 180 degrees plus 180 degrees is 360 degrees. So we can cancel 180 degrees plus 180 degrees and 360 degrees. We can also cancel negative 2 times p and positive 2 times p. Therefore, we are left with negative 2 alpha plus beta equals 0. So obviously, alpha is 1/2 of beta. So that proves the statement or the theorem that the peripheral or inscribed angle alpha is 1/2 the measure of its subtended arc, which is in this case 1/2 of beta. The subtended arc is defined by this measure beta or the central angle beta. Then for the second proof or demonstration, let us consider A prime and CD, A prime CD, triangle A prime CD. So we draw a line from A prime to C, and that's the radius again from C to A prime, or A prime to C. That's the radius again. Therefore, we have isosceles triangles A prime CD. That's an isosceles triangle. And we also have an isosceles triangle A prime BC. This is also an isosceles triangle because that's the radius. This is also the radius of the circle. So if I call this angle, the measure of this angle mu, which is defined by angle C A prime D, then angle D A prime C is also mu, because this mu, because this is an isosceles triangle. So this is also mu. Therefore, because triangle A prime CB or A prime BC is an isosceles triangle RR, and the total angle here is mu plus alpha or mu plus alpha, this measure of the angle is also mu plus alpha. So that's it. Then if this angle is, I'll call this gamma, then gamma in this triangle, the sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degrees, or gamma is 180 degrees minus 2 times mu plus alpha, quantity mu times alpha. So gamma is 180 degrees minus 2 times quantity mu plus alpha. So if that is the value of gamma, considering triangle A prime CD, in triangle A prime CD, the sum of the interior angles is 180 degrees. And the interior angles are lambda, beta, and mu. So 2 mu. So in triangle A prime CD, lambda or gamma plus beta plus 2 times mu equals 180 degrees. Substituting the value of gamma, which is 180 degrees minus 2 times quantity mu plus alpha, then plus beta plus 2 mu equals 180 degrees. So removing grouping symbols, 180 degrees minus 2 mu minus 2 times alpha plus beta plus 2 mu equals 180 degrees. Then we can cancel 180 degrees. We can also cancel negative 2 mu and positive 2 mu, leaving this equation which is similar to this. So therefore, alpha is 1/2 of beta, 1/2 the corresponding central angle beta. Finally, let's consider this situation where the limiting position of this point on the periphery of the circle is either at point B or point D, the ends of the subtended arc, so that in particular when point A is coincident with point B, then that this is the first chord and the other chord reduces to a tangent. So the tangent, that's why the measure of this angle is also alpha, because it subtends the same arc. So if this is the tangent, this tangent line and this radius are perpendicular to each other by principle. So in the third situation, so this is now 90 degrees. So that means this, the measure of this angle is 90 degrees minus alpha, as shown. And I'll call it lambda, where lambda is 90 degrees minus alpha. And because triangle DC or triangle A double prime CD is another isosceles triangle, because that's the radius, and one angle is lambda, this angle which is equal to lambda, so this is also lambda. So in triangle A double prime CD, the sum of the interior angles is 180 degrees, or simply beta is beta plus 2 lambda equals 180 degrees, or beta plus 2 times lambda equals 180 degrees, where lambda is 90 degrees minus alpha. So in triangle A double prime CD, lambda is 90 degrees minus alpha, and beta plus 2 times lambda equals 180 degrees. Again, beta plus lambda, or beta plus 2 lambda, the sum of the interior angles of this triangle is 180 degrees. Substituting the value of lambda, which is 90 degrees minus alpha equals 180 degrees, then expanding, beta plus 180 degrees minus 2 alpha is 180 degrees. Again, we can cancel 180 degrees. And this equation reduces to the same equation as this. Therefore, alpha is 1/2 of beta. So that's it. In general, if you have a circle and we have a diameter, from any point on the periphery of the circle to the ends of the diameter, chords are drawn, and those chords are perpendicular to each other, or the angle between the chords joining the ends of the diameter is always half of the measure of the subtended arc, because this is half circle, and therefore this angle, the measure of this angle, is 180 degrees. Then by the principle demonstrated here or shown here, from any point to the ends of the diameter, this, the measure of the angle or the angle between the chords to the ends of the diameter, is half of 180 degrees, and therefore that's always 90 degrees. So if the point is here joining the ends of the diameter, the chords make an angle equal to half of 180 degrees, or that's 90 degrees, always perpendicular. In short, any triangle where the longest side, the hypotenuse, is the diameter, is a right triangle. So again, any triangle where the hypotenuse is the diameter is always a right triangle. And the diameter or the hypotenuse is equal to the diameter of the circumscribing circle. So, likewise, if this is the point joining the ends of the diameter, the chords are always 90 degrees. So, this is the point joining the ends of the diameter, that's 90 degrees. So, for the case where we have a tangent, that's a tangent. The tangent in this case is vertical and the radius is horizontal or along the diameter. So, that's why this is 90 degrees horizontal. vertical and horizontal, vertical, horizontal, so that's 90 degrees for the third case here. So that's it, and I hope that you learned a new principle which is very important in geometry and in trigonometry in deriving formulas for different situations. And I hope that you can recall this principle.